5 years ago, Civil Spider dated a girl who he couldn't stop thinking about. A year into their relationship, she decided to break up with him in the worst way he can imagine. One morning, on his way to do some volunteer work for his church on Easter, Civil Spider texted his girlfriend to say good morning. However, there was no answer. Thinking she was busy, he let it go for 6 hours until he was on his way home. In the car with his entire family, Civil Spider saw a text from his girlfriend's best friend saying that she was dead. He tried not to cry in front of his whole family. When he got home, Civil Spider locked himself in his bedroom and cried for the rest of the day. Later, he found out she really wasn't dead, since dead people can't block others on Steam.
Salty Squid was getting his freak on with his girlfriend one night when he disrobed in front of her. At that time, he must have been really fucking skinny because as soon as he had done that, she screamed, "You look like a Holocaust victim!" and ran from the room in a fit of giggles. They still laugh about it to this day. Man, that's kind of fucked up though.
Dumbest lie I've ever tried to tell somebody is when my legs was on fire. It wasn't really on fire, but that's what I told them on the phone. I was talking to my friend and I was like, "Please! Please! I need your help! I need your help!" And he freaked out and he was like, "Pringle, what's wrong? What do you need help with?" And I told him, "My leg is on fire! My leg is on fire!" And then he said, "Oh my gosh! Please, man, just call 911. I'll be there right now." And then I told him, "It's on fire! You know why? Because my mixtape is so good!" After that, my friend hung up the phone and he never talked to me since. www.pringletheone at soundcloud.com. Let's go. One time, Kubi and her sister, Sacred Snoopy, decided to play a prank on their mother. So they stuffed old clothes in a pillow. Then they drew a creepy face on some paper which they taped to the pillow. They put the pillow in the shower and waited for their mother to discover it. Once she saw it, their mother screamed, "What the hell?" and ran out of the bathroom. For their punishment, their mother made them rub their stepdad's hairy, pimply back.
Ramona met her future husband in a hotel lobby in Chicago. He was a handsome goth gentleman playing the Addams Family theme song on piano. When he finished, Ramona went over to compliment him on his playing. But before she could get a word out, the handsome goth man looked at her extremely excited and said,
"Hey, are those real?"
Ramona gasped and covered her chest. She was about to yell him for being a perv when he said,
No, I meant your eyes.
He told Ramona that her eyes were really interesting, and he wondered if they were contacts. After that hilarious misunderstanding, the two spent the whole weekend together. 6 months later, they were living together, and a few years after that, they got married. The next step is to start their own Addams Family.
A long time ago, when Mimi was on the bus to go home, a tipsy homeless man stumbled onto the bus. He walked very clumsily and had a crooked grimace on his face. He constantly went from seat to seat, sitting next to people. At one point, he even leaned in close to a lady's face like he was about to kiss her. Everyone, including Mimi, sat in shock and silence. Eventually, he sat across from Mimi and started arguing and yelling at cars passing by like he was delusional. As she was about to leave the bus, Mimi glanced back to see him stroke and lick the bus pole. He said to everyone, "Isn't she beautiful?"
In middle school, Zara Kanba was one of the first kids in his class to get himself a girlfriend. One day, she invited him over after school to have a bounce on a trampoline. It was going great when she decided to go inside and get them some drinks. Zaraganba decided to stay outside and keep jumping. He realized he really needed to fart, so he said to himself,
"Hey, why not let one out while she's inside?"
Unfortunately, when he went to let one rip, the force of his bouncing caused Zaraganba to crap his pants. He could smell it instantly. It was the unmistakable stench of dookie. Zaraganba knew he couldn't face his girlfriend, so he bounced his poo-stained ass off that trampoline and sprinted home. When he thinks back on that memory, his butthole clenches up from the sheer force of the cringe.
Hellbent was 6 years old. He took a family skiing trip to Virginia. They stayed in a private cabin just outside a resort. One night, Hellbent was sleeping off a big day on the slopes when he woke to a strange laughter coming from outside. As he listened harder, the laughter turned into creepy singing. The person singing was saying,
"Come a, come a get you. Come a, come a get you."
A terrified Hellbent quickly woke his entire family. The family huddled together as the intruder started scratching at their window. When the back door suddenly opened, Hellbent's dad told him to hide in the closet. As he dialed 911, the creepy singing got closer and closer. The psychopath burst into their room, shouting and swearing. He was just about to open the closet door when suddenly, the resort security tackled him and put him under arrest. Apparently, this intruder had escaped from jail that night. He'd been in there for all sorts of things, like assault, breaking and entering, kidnapping, and he was hoping to add murder to that list.
Tolop and his brother went to the park to think of ideas for his Star Wars party. Tolop's brother got his friend and they came up with the idea to take all of Tolop's stuffing, fill him up with candy, hang him from a tree branch, and have everyone hit him with a stick until he breaks open and everyone eats the candy that spills out. Tolop had a hard time walking his brother home that day, so his commander got a little bit too excited when he went to an opening day of a baseball game once. He drank so much beer during the game that he went to a casino afterwards and bet his entire life savings on a blackjack table. He, of course, lost it all, and then proceeded to run to an empty car park and vomit until he thought he was going to explode. He was laying in a ball while his friends tried to lift him into a car to take him home. Fortunately, he recovered, but he learned a hard lesson that day. When Melissa was in 8th grade, her social studies class had a pet gecko. Melissa read the list of rules next to his enclosure, and noticed the first one said, "Never try to rip off the gecko's tail." Melissa thought this was really weird, so he asked the teacher about it. The teacher told her the rule was made because a past student tried to rip the gecko's tail off to gross out the other students. The gecko ended up biting him in self-defense. He had to go to the nurse's office and tried suing the school.
When Zaragonbo was 14, his mom gave him a job at a local hockey arena. When the teams finished practice, Zaragonbo had to skate over and collect the pucks before the Zamboni cleaned the ice. Zaragonbo was paid over $100 for just 2 minutes of work. In a couple of months, he was able to save up thousands of dollars, which he proceeded to blow on video games and dates with his girlfriend. Best job ever.
Andy Mations went out with some friends for a New Year's Eve party. The party was vintage themed and everyone was dressed up nicely. Andy had a dress with fringes that got stuck basically everywhere. She was already pretty drunk and distanced herself from the crowd. That's when she found a cat that hissed at her. So Andy hissed back and got into a staring contest with the cat. Her friend tried to get her back to the party, but Andy then hissed and clawed at him. Then she got on all fours and attempted to dash away. But her fringy dress got caught on a bush and she fell face first instead. She had to be carried home because she blacked out after hitting the ground.
Spinal Palm had a crush on this girl, and one day, she invited him to her house to hang out. For a while, they just sat around and played video games until she said to him, "I hear you have a crush on me. Is that true?" He nodded, and she paused the game. She told him to follow her to her room, and when Spinal Palm got inside, he saw a snake that was about 6 feet long in a glass case. She pointed to the snake and said that its name was Sylvester, and told him that if he really had a crush on her, then he would let Sylvester slither all over him. Spinal Palm reluctantly accepted her challenge, and she got the snake out from the case. She put the snake on the floor, and it slithered towards him. It started to travel up his leg, and from that point on, he stood absolutely still, hoping that the snake wouldn't bite him. Her face lit up and she gasped in awe. When the snake was done slithering all over him, she put it back in its cage and gave Spinal Palm a big kiss.
When Nixium was little, he suspected that his grandma was a little on the insane side. Whenever she was babysitting him, she had a bizarre way of making sure Nixium behaved himself. If he so much as made a loud noise or said anything mean, she would sneak up next to him and bite his ear. Sometimes she would appear out of nowhere and nibble on his lobes. Needless to say, he was constantly on his best behavior around her. He still has nightmares about the old woman's breath in his ears while she bites him in his sleep.
When Melissa was in 6th grade, she was called to the principal's office. Dun dun dun! The principal blamed her for creating this mean gossip site that told lies about students and exposed their secrets. It had stuff like who was cheating on who had been underage drinking, and who was secretly gay. The school thought Melissa was responsible because she'd somehow been listed as the website's administrator. But Melissa had never made a website before and tried to convince them all it was a mistake. The principal looked through her school iPad and found no evidence to support his accusation, but that didn't stop him from calling Melissa's parents and suspending her for a week. When she returned from her suspension, the other students gave her dirty looks. A few days later, the real culprit was found. He was caught editing the website during class on his iPad. He had posed as Melissa, making it look like she'd created the website. The school gave Melissa a heartfelt apology while the culprit was given a 3-month suspension. and some compulsory summer school classes.
When Sacred Snoopy was 12 years old, she rode the school bus back home from school when she heard a group of older kids in the back of the bus laughing and gasping. Curious, she turned around and saw the girl known throughout the school as the Skank, totally giving head to the most popular guy on the football team. Snoopy turned around quickly and sunk down in her seat out of sheer discomfort. She noticed that the driver was glaring angrily at the sexual deed going on, but he didn't stop it. The next day, the girl never showed up for school, and Snoopy learned from another kid that the driver had showed the Skank's parents a little security video from the bus during that eventful day. And from then on, there was a little yellow sticker next to the camera that said, "Smile for the camera." Snoopy stopped riding the school bus and carpooled until graduation day. Wait a second, isn't it a little bit creepy that the bus driver kept that video?
Pandora used to be a customer service operator at a major internet provider. One day, she had a customer call in, demanding to know why they couldn't access their email. They were very angry about it, so they needed to send an email immediately to isolate the problem. Pandora asked if their internet was working, and they said, "The internet is down! I don't care about that right now! I need my email! I will call about my internet later!" Pandora just shook her head and thought, "Idiot!" Hellbent School had a rule against students having facial hair. This is actually pretty normal, but the strange part is the dean of Hellbent School likes to come around to the classrooms and personally enforce the rule. Every morning he barges in, puts his hands all over the male students' faces to check for the slightest sign of facial hair. If he feels any fuzz at all, he publicly embarrasses the student by making them shave it off with a dispensable razor. I'm guessing that guy was projecting some kind of childhood trauma involving a mustache or something.
Emoji's most disturbing secret is he walked in on his friend's parents having sex when he was 8 years old. It was when him and his friend were having a climbing race to the roof. Emoji's friend wanted to climb up there through her bedroom window, and she told Emoji to do the same thing from her parents' window. Playing along, Emoji snuck into her parents' room to execute their stealthy plan. What he didn't expect to see, however, was his friend's parents going at it like rabbits at noon, with company visiting. Emoji never told his friend what he saw, but he could tell something was wrong. Poor Emoji. He's seen some shit.
When Tallup was young, he would eat leaves from the ground. I have no idea why he did this, but for a little while, when his nanny took him and his siblings to the park, he would walk around the slides and just look for leaves that had fallen out of trees, and then he would just quickly eat them.
When he was in the fourth grade, Mikhailum had a girlfriend who was the type of person who only liked smart boys. At the time, he had all A's, and so they went out for about 2 months until midterms came up. He ended up getting one F. When she saw Mikhailum's grade, she saw the F and said,
"Well, I guess the F is for fuck off!"
Then she spat all over him, so Mikhailum got mad and pushed her. He was then taken out of the classroom.
The mother of Mikhail M's girlfriend was someone who always had to be right about everything. One time, his girlfriend's mom made cookies that got stuck to the parchment paper. She began yelling and fighting with everyone, demanding they eat the paper attached to the cookies. It was just because she made them. Another time, Mikhail M and his girlfriend and her parents went out to eat at a Chinese restaurant. All of a sudden, his girlfriend's mom began yelling at everyone because they weren't using chopsticks. Her reasoning was that they were eating Chinese food, and that they eat with chopsticks in China. But the dumbest thing Mikhailum ever fought with his girlfriend's mom about was when she started yelling and screaming at him about there being trash in the trash can. So, he yelled back, asking about where else trash would go. Her response was, "It's not my problem, but there shouldn't be trash in the trash can!" That entire argument went on for about 15 minutes. To this day, Mikhailum still doesn't know where he should put the trash, but he still puts it in the trash can. Froggy was walking down the hallway in her high school when she heard arguing coming from the cafeteria. She decided to investigate and, upon entering the cafeteria, saw two girls fighting with each other. Froggy asked one of her friends what was going on, and he told her that the girls were fighting about who had a better cell phone case. The girls said things like,
"My cell phone case is better than yours, you fucking slut!"
And
Well, my phone case is better because it has glitter on the side and yours looks like a color of puke.
To this day, those girls continue to argue about their cell phone cases.
Nixiam got paid $200 to follow a group of college friends around and go bar hopping on a Saturday night. At first, Nixiam thought they wanted him to be a designated driver, but that wasn't it at all. They wanted an older person to hang out with them and have fancy drinks to make them look more sophisticated or something. Nixiam didn't really get it, but they paid him $200 and bought him drinks, so he had no complaints.
I think Dolan might have been a cat in a past life. His weirdest secret is he likes to sleep on top of his dresser. Every night, his mom would tuck him into bed, kiss him on the head, and say, "Sweet dreams, honey." But as soon as she was gone, Dolan would jump out of bed and climb up onto his favorite dresser. He would always spend the night up there with some thick quilts and fluffy pillows. Somehow, Dolan kept this a secret for 8 months. That is, until the day he got his foot stuck in a drawer. He couldn't make it out on his own, so he had to call his mom for help. She came to the rescue, and, Dolan got into a lot of trouble.
When Gurgak was walking to a hospital to visit his grandpa, he bumped into a rich-looking mom. Of course, he said sorry to her. However, she said that he was a polite guy and wanted him to name her two sons for $20. He said,
"Wait, so what? I can just name someone and get $20?
Gurgak ended up accepting the offer, and he went into a room that had the infants in the capsules. He stood there, thinking about names for roughly 30 minutes. He then started to think about games like Call of Duty Final Verdict. He suggested the older son be Nico, and the younger one, Cross. The mom was so happy she handed Gurgak the $20. Dean has always loved spending time with his girlfriend, and their favorite thing to do together is writing songs. His girlfriend will sing and write lyrics while Dean plays along on his ocarina. One day, Dean's girlfriend came over and was acting very excited about some new lyrics she wrote. She asked Dean to play along with her, and they started jamming. As they were playing, Dean listened to the lyrics and realized something strange. It sounded like the song was about a woman cheating on her man with his best friend. When they got to the chorus, Dean stopped playing and asked if the song was about her. She admitted it was autobiographical and that she'd hooked up with his friend. Dean broke up with her and got the hell out of there. He then went straight to his friend's house, broke the guy's hand, and never spoke to either of them again.
When Zaraganba was a student in a community college, he had some trouble with math. So he decided to try the free math tutors they have in the library, hoping they could help him with his homework. Zaraganba got in there and signed up, only to find out that the tutors are not allowed to help with anything that's graded. So he was not allowed to ask for help on any of the math problems on his homework, which was the only reason he went there. When he asked why the rule was in place, the only explanation they gave was that
it wasn't fair to the other people taking the same class.
The problem with that is that the tutoring service was free and available to all students. So how exactly was it not fair that Zaraganba asked for help when literally everyone else could do the same? Zaraganba kept bringing this up, but they just continued on the
"it's not fair" line.
At recess, when Shima was in fifth grade, she heard the supervisor blow her whistle, getting everyone's attention. She pointed and screamed, "Bear!" in the distance. Shima could see a black bear coming from the woods. Everyone rushed into the school as fast as they could. The bear hung around, and they were kept on lockdown as it sniffed at the doors. When the authorities came, it had already gone back into the woods. Shima's teacher had asked why they thought a bear came so close, since normally they would steer away. Shima remembered reading a book where animals will behave oddly when sensing some kind of danger, so she answered that it could be the Mount St. Helens volcano nearby. The teacher doubted it, of course, but told Shima, "If anything like that happens tomorrow, I will give you 100 extra credit points in whatever subject, and the next day 50. The day after the next, the same supervisor blew her whistle after hearing over the intercom that Mount St. Helens had activated a bit. So Shima got 50 extra credit points. The kids were even cheering. Shima gets 50 points. Shima gets 50 points.
In sixth grade, Legna had a huge crush on a girl. When he was 12 years old, his nervousness and talking without thinking made for one of the biggest regrets of his life. He was breathing and sweating heavily, so she asked what was wrong. He quickly said,
Will you please shut the fudge up? I'm trying to think of a flirty and catchy pickup line.
Luckily, she didn't understand a thing he said, so she asked him to repeat it. Then Legna messed up again, saying, nothing. You're just so beautiful I melted and wet my pants. She said,
holy what?
He quickly replied,
holy shit, you stupid bitch!
Legna was referring to himself, but she ran away and cried for the rest of lunchtime. At the end of afternoon class, he apologized and explained what happened, but he landed in the friend zone for about 4 to 5 months.
When Emoji was 7 years old, he went to a superhero-themed kids' party. The birthday boy's mom had arranged for a very special guest to show up. While Emoji and his friends were eating ice cream, Superman suddenly walked through the door. They rushed over to meet their hero, but one kid at the party just stood at the back without so much as a smile. He soon pulled out a pistol and pointed it at Superman. The adults screamed and pulled their kids away. The kid with the gun said if the guy in the costume really was Superman, the bullet would bounce right off him. It took 15 minutes, but the man dressed as Superman eventually talked the kid into handing over the gun. Police arrived and talked to everyone about gun safety. It could have gone really bad, but in the end, Emoji found it a surprisingly fun party. His favorite part was the cake.
A friend of mine told me the story, and it sounded so ludicrous, I didn't even think it could have been real. But turns out, it was true. One day, she was driving along, doing the legal speed limit, and got pulled over by a cop. She had no idea what she'd done wrong, so of course she was confused when the cop walked over to give her a ticket. She asked him, "What's the charge, officer?" He looked at her, smiled, and then said, "Driving without my number," and winked. This is the kind of thing you see in a bad porno. I didn't really think it would happen in real life, but it was actually a thing that happened. I really hope this crooked cop lost his license.
One time in science class, MCALM and his classmates were doing an experiment. If a student fucked up, the whole experiment could explode. One student got distracted while doing a step, leaving a mixture of chemicals on the Bunsen burner for too long. The teacher noticed the mixture was bubbling and ran to the student, throwing himself on top of him. He yelled for everyone to get down. MCALM and the other students threw themselves to the floor, just as the experiment went up like a bomb. The explosion caused a chain reaction, and the other experiments began to explode. A window next to MCALM was blown out from one of the other explosions, and he got covered with broken shards of glass. Everyone, including the teacher, had to go to the emergency room afterward. MCALM ended up getting 13 stitches and several scars on his back.
James Shark was with his father just ahead of a young couple at the bus stop. The couple were talking about sex toys and how sexy it would be to use a butt plug with a tail. Thing is, James Shark lived in Spain and was the only one who knew both Spanish and English in his family. His father asked what was going on, which made James Shark nervous, but he decided to translate everything he heard. His dad had the same reaction. They didn't talk anymore at all till he got onto the bus away from that couple.
Helbin's housemate invited a girl once over, and he assured Helbin that she would be sleeping outside in her car. She gave Helbin a strange look, but he just shrugged it off. It was this point he saw that his underwear drawer was wide open, and his door was open too. He went to investigate and saw the basement light was on. He slowly walked towards the door and opened it, and stood in shock at what he saw. His housemate's friend was standing butt naked, sniffing his underwear. She ran out the house with his underwear and drove off, still butt naked. He immediately told his housemate and they never heard from her again.